Hi students, how are you? Hope you are all doing well. And for the last three videos, I have been explaining you one of the important topics in grammar in intermediate second year, word stress. And up to now, we have completed three videos as three parts. And today, we are going to have this fourth part and the final one. Okay, so in the previous videos, I have explained you what is word stress and how to identify word stress. And to identify word stress, I have told you 6 rules. And out of 6 rules, we have completed 4 rules in the previous videos. And today, we are going to learn the 5th rule and the 6th rule. And we are going to have some examples on 5th rule and 6th rule. So, what is this rule number 5? So, if the words are ending with, if a given word is ending with ion, ial, ic, ious or eous, then the stress should be on the second syllable from the last. Okay, understand? If a given word is ending with ion or ial or ic or ious or eous, then the stress should be on the second syllable from the last, but not from the starting. It should be from the ending. Second syllable from the ending. This is very important. Now let's see some examples. Okay, first of all, let us see the words which are ending with ion. Okay, so these words are ending with ion. If you observe carefully, you can find that these words are ending with ion. So education, preparation, confusion, vacation. Okay, now let's see how to mark stress for these words. So, you already know to mark stress for any word, then you have to first divide that word into syllables. Okay, right? So, what are the syllables here? Education. So, here the syllables are A, Ju, K, Shun. A, Ju, K, Shun. Totally there are 4 syllables in this word. And this word is ending with ion. So, if the word is ending with ion, the stress should be on the second syllable from the last. What is the second syllable from the last? This is from the starting, this is from the ending. So, we have to count from the ending. So, Shun, this is the first syllable. C-A, K, this is the second syllable. So, according to the rule, you put the stress on the second syllable. Therefore, you put the stress here on K, C-A-K. So, like that. Then, it can be pronounced as education. Education. Okay. While pronouncing this word, we have to give more stress. And we have to highlight the sound C-A-K. The remaining syllables should be pronounced with lower force. Okay, understand? Education. Education. Okay, now let's see another example. Preparation. So, what are the syllables here? Pre. Pa. Re. T-I-O-N. Shun. Okay, so from the ending, we have to take the second syllable. What is the first syllable? T-I-O-N, Shun. What is the second syllable? R-A, Re. So, you put the stress on Re. That means, on the letter R, you put this vertical bar like this. Okay, then it will be preparation. Preparation. It should be pronounced as preparation. R-A, Re should be highlighted. Okay, now let's see another one. Confusion. What are the syllables? Con. Confusion. Confusion. There are 3 syllables in this word. So, the last syllable is gen. S-I-O-N, gen. And the second, this is the first syllable from the last. What is the second syllable? Few. So, you put the stress mark on F-U, few. Then it will be confusion. Confusion. Okay, understand? This word is ending with I-O-N. If the word is ending with ion, the stress should be on the second syllable from the last. What is the second syllable from the last? S-I-O-N, gen. This is the first syllable. F-U, few. This is the second syllable. Okay, understand? So, we put the stress mark on the syllable, few. Okay, now let's go to another word. Vacation. V-A-C-A-T-I-O-N. Vacation. So, what are the syllables? V-A, way. K-T-I-O-N, shun. There are three syllables in this word, and this word is ending with ion. So from the last, what is the second syllable? Tion. Shun is the first syllable. Ca, k, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress mark on the syllable ca k. Then it will be vacation. Vacation. Okay, understand? So these are some examples for the words which are ending with ion. Now let's see some words which are ending with IAL. Okay, understand? So you see the social. S-O-C-I-A-L, social. What are the syllables? S-O. So, C-I-A-L, shell. Okay, this is the first syllable from the end. This is the first syllable. This is the second syllable. So according to the rule, the stress should be on the second syllable if the word is ending with IAL. So this word is ending with IAL. So you put the stress on the second syllable. Second syllable means you have to remember from the end second syllable, not from the starting, but from the ending. This is starting, this is ending. What is the second syllable from the ending? C-I-A-L, shall. This is the first syllable. S-O-S-O, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress mark on the syllable, so. Then it will be social. Social. Okay, now let's see another one. Financial. Okay, what are the syllables? Fe. N-A-N. Nan. Shall. Financial. F-I. Fe. N-A-N. Nan. C-I-A-L, shall. So this word is also ending with I-A-L. So you put the stress mark on the second syllable from the last. So shall, this is the first syllable. Nan, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress mark on the syllable N-A-N, nan. Then it will be financial. Financial, while pronouncing it should be financial. The syllable nan should be highlighted. It should be pronounced with higher force. So, financial. Okay, next you see another word. Remedial. Remedial. R-E-R-E-M-E-M-E-D-I-A-L. Dull. Remedial. So, this is the first syllable and this is the second syllable. So, you put the stress mark on the me, then it will be pronounced as remedial. Remedial. This is not remedial. Okay, understand? Remedial. And last one is ceremonial. Ceremonial. What are the syllables? Sir. Mo. Nal. C-E-R-E. Sir. M-O. Mo. N-I-A-L. Nal. Ceremonial. So this word is ending with I-A-L. If the word is ending with IAL, according to the rule, the stress should be on the second syllable from the end. So, what is the second syllable from the end? N-I-A-L, null. This is the first one. M-O, mo. This is the second syllable. So, you put the stress mark on the syllable, mo. Then it will be ceremonial. Ceremonial. Okay, understand? So, these are some of the examples for the words which are ending with IAL. Now let's see some words which end with IC. Okay, so for the words which end with IC also, they take the stress on the second syllable from the last. So you see this word, historic. Historic. What are the syllables? H-I-S. His. To. Rick. Historic. So 1, 2, 3. There are three syllables. So, according to the rule, we have to take the second syllable from the end. So, Rick, this is the first syllable. T-O-T-O, this is the second syllable. So, you put the stress mark on T-O-T-O. Then it will be historic. 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 Okay, understand? Now you go to another one, logic. What are the syllables? L-O, long. G-I-C, jig. Long, jig. This is the first syllable from the end. This is the second syllable from the end. So we need second syllable from the end. You already know. So you put the stress mark on L-O, law. Then it will be logic. Logic. Okay. Now you see this. F-A-N-A-T-I-C, fanatic. F-A-N-A-T-I-C, fanatic. So what are the syllables? Fa, N-A, na, T-I-C, tick, fanatic. So this is the first syllable. This is the second syllable. You have to remember that we should count the syllables from the last, but not from the starting. Okay, you remember this. So tick, first syllable. Na, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress mark on the syllable. N-A, na. Then it will be fanatic. Fanatic. So while pronouncing this word, we have to apply higher force on the syllable N-A, na. So fanatic, like that. Okay. And finally, magnetic. M-A-G-N-E-T-I-C, magnetic. What are the syllables? Mag. M-A-G, mag. N-E, ne. T-I-C, tick. Mag, ne, tick. Okay, this is the first syllable and N-E, ne, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress mark on ne. Then it will be magnetic. 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 Okay. And finally, the words which end with I-O-S or E-O-U-S. Okay. Now you see this. Courageous. Courageous. What are the syllables? Courageous. This is not courageous. Okay, understand? It should be pronounced as courageous. Courageous. Okay. This word is ending with E-O-U-S. So if the word is ending with E-O-U-S, the stress should be on the second syllable from the last, according to the fifth rule. So what is the second syllable from the last? Just, this is the first syllable, and re, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress mark on re, like this. So courageous, courageous. Okay. And the next one, ambitious. A-M-B-I-T-I-O-U-S, ambitious. So am B-I-B, shes, ambitious. Okay, ambitious. So this word is ending with I-O-U-S. If it is ending with I-O-U-S or E-O-U-S, then the stress should be on the second syllable from the last. So this is the first syllable and B-I-B, this is the second syllable. So you put the stress on the syllable B, then it will be ambitious. Ambitious. Okay. Next one, courteous. C-O-U-R-T-E-O-U-S. Courteous. So, C-O-U-R. Court. Courteous. Courteous. C-O-U-R. Courteous. There are two syllables. This is the first syllable. This is the second syllable. So we need to put the stress on the second syllable itself. So you put the stress mark here. Courteous. Courteous. Okay. Next, delicious. Delicious. D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. Delicious. So what are the syllables? D-E-D-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. Okay. D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. Delicious. So this is the first syllable and L-I-L-I is the second syllable from the last. So you put the stress mark on L-I. So delicious. Okay. So if the words are ending with I-O-N, I-A-L, I-C, I-O-U-S or E-O-U-S, then the stress should be on the second syllable from the last. Okay. This word, this last is very important. We should not count from the starting. We have to count from the ending. Then only you will be able to put the stress mark correctly. Okay. So this is about rule number 5. Now let's see some examples for rule number 6. And in the previous video, I have already explained you what about this rule number 6. So the rule number 6 says, if a given word is ending with, IAN, remember in the rule number 5, this is ION. ION, this is IAN, don't be confused, okay. So if a given word is ending with IAN, ICAL, ITY, IZE, LOGY, or graphy, GREPHY, graphy, then the stress should be on the third syllable from the end. So the fifth rule says that the stress will be on the second syllable from the last. Okay, the sixth rule says that third syllable from the last, end or last, both are okay. So third syllable from the last. Okay, so now let's see some examples which are ending with IAN. Okay, so you see this word Indian. Indian, what are the syllables? In, D, N. Indian, there are three syllables in this word. So according to the rule, the stress should be on the third syllable from the last, because this word is ending with IAN. So what is the third syllable from the last? From the last means from here. Okay, N, first one, DID, second syllable, IN, IN, this is the third syllable. So you put the stress mark on IN, IN, then it will be Indian, Indian. Okay, next, Guardian, Guardian. So what are the syllables? G-U-A-R, guard, D, N. This is similar to Indian. Okay, so Guardian, there are three syllables like this. So that you put the stress mark on third syllable. Okay, next, Musician, Mu, G, She, N. Mu, M-U, Mu, S-I-C-G, C-I, C-A-N, Mu, G, She, N. Okay, so the third syllable from the end. So, A-N-N, first syllable, C-I, She, second syllable, S-I-G, this is the third syllable. So, you put the stress mark on the syllable G. Then it will be musician, musician. Okay. And finally, comedian. Co, M-E, me, D-I-D-A-N. There are four syllables again. Co, me, D-N. This is the first one, D, D-I-D. Second one, M-E, me, this is the third syllable. So you put the stress mark on me, then it will be comedian. Okay, understand? So these are some examples for the words which are ending with IAN. Now let's see some examples which end with ICAL. Okay, you see this optical, O-P-T-I-C-A-L, optical. So what are the syllables here? Op-t-cal, T-cal. There are three syllables in this word, and this word is ending with I-C-A-L. I-C-A-L. So if a given word is ending with I-C-A-L, according to the rule, the stress should be on the third syllable from the last. So what is the third syllable from the last? This is the first one, second one, and this is the third one. So you put the stress mark on op. Optical. Okay. Next, historical. Historical. H-I-S, his, to, re-cal. Historical. 1, 2, 3, 4, there are four syllables, and we need to put the stress mark on the third syllable from the last. So 1, 2, 3, T or 2, this is the third syllable. So you put the stress mark here, then it will be historical. Historical. Okay, and you see this word practical. Practical. P-R-A, pra, P-R-A-C, prac, T-I, T-cal, prac, T-cal. There are three syllables. So the third syllable from the end, 1, 2, 3. So you put the stress mark on the third syllable, prac, practical. Okay, in the same way, grammatical. Grammatical. G-R-A-M. Gram. G-R-A-M. Gram. This is one syllable. And M-A. May. This is the second syllable. You see this. These two M should be divided between these two syllables. Okay, G-R-A-M. Gram. One syllable. M-A. May. Second syllable. T-I-T. Third syllable. And C-A-L, another syllable. So totally 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables are there. And according to the rule, we should put the stress mark on the third syllable from the last. So 1, 2, 3. M-A, may. This is the third syllable. So you put the stress mark on the second M. So grammatical. Grammatical. So these are some examples for the words which are ending with I-C-A-L. Now let's see the words which end with ity. Okay. So for the words which end with ity also, we should put the stress mark on the third syllable from the last. So you see this word visibility. V-I-S-I-B-I-L-I-T-Y. Visibility. First of all, let's divide this word into syllables. So V-S-I-G-B-I-B. L-I, li, T-Y, T. Okay, V-I, V, this is one syllable. S-I-G, this is the another syllable. B-I, B, third one. L-I, li, and T-Y, T. Totally, there are 5 syllables in this word. Okay, and this word is ending with I-T-Y. If you observe carefully, I-T-Y. If it is ending with I-T-Y, then also, we put the stress mark on the third syllable from the last. So what is the third syllable from the last? T-Y-T, first one. L-I-L-I, second one. B-I-B, this is the third syllable. So you put the stress mark on B-I-B. Then it will be pronounced as visibility. 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 Okay. Next, legibility. L-E-G-I-B-I-L-I-T-Y, legibility. First, let's divide this word into syllables. So, lay, L-E-L-A, G-I-G, B-I-B, L-I-L-E, T-Y, T, legibility. This is similar to visibility. So, third syllable from the last, T, first one, lay, second one, again, B, third one. So, you put the stress mark on B. Then it will be legibility. Legibility. Okay. Next, possibility. Okay. So, P-O-S. Pause. P-O-S. Pause. S-I-G. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 syllables are there. And we need to put the stress on the third syllable from the last. So, what is the third syllable? 1, 2, and 3, B again. So you put the stress mark on B here. So possibility. Okay, next you see another word. Opportunity. Opportunity. O-P. Op. Per. Chu. Ni. T. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 syllables are there. So what is the third syllable from the end? 1, 2, 3, T-U-T-U. So, you put the stress mark on T-U-T-U. Then, opportunity. Opportunity. Okay. So, these are some words. Now, let's see the words which end with I-Z-E. Okay. What is the first word? Emphasize. E-M-P-H-A-S-I-Z-E. Emphasize. Emphasize. So, E-M, M, P-H-A, for size, S-I-Z-E, size. There are 3 syllables. So, we need to put the stress on the third syllable from the last. Then, what will be the third syllable from the last? It will be nothing but first syllable. 1, 2, 3, emphasize. So, you put the stress mark on emphasize. Emphasize. Okay. Next, humanize. H-U-M-A-N-I-Z-E. This is similar to this word. H-U-M-A. Ma. nij. So you put the stress on the third syllable from the end, then it will be humanize. Okay, now let's see another word, symbolize. S-Y-M, symbolize. There are three syllables and we need to put the stress on the third syllable from the end. So what is the third syllable from the end? 1, 2, 3. So symbolize. Symbolize. And finally, authorize. Authorize. A-U-R-T-H-O-R-I-S-E. There are three syllables. So you put the stress mark on the third syllable from the end. 1, 2, 3. So authorize. Okay, so now let's see some examples which end with L-O-G-Y, logy. Okay, so what is the word? Anthropology. Anthropology. First, let's divide this word into syllables. So, anthropology. A-N, anthro, P-O, po, L-O, lo, G-Y, G. And this word is ending with L-O-G-Y, logy. So in this case, the stress should be on the third syllable from the end. So here totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 syllables are there. So what is the third syllable from the last? G-Y-G, first one. L-O, law, this is the second one. P-O, po, this is the third one. So you put the stress mark on the syllable po, then it will be anthropology, anthropology, anthropology. Next, anthology, A-N-T-H-O-L-O-G-Y, anthology, N-T-H-O, T-H-O-L-O-G, anthology, 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables are there. What is the third syllable from the last? G-Y-G, first one. Law, second one, T-H-O, tha, this is the third syllable. So you put the stress mark on T-H-O, tha. Then it should be pronounced as anthology. Anthology. Okay. Next, theology. T-H-E-O-L-O-G-Y, theology. First, let's divide this word into syllables. So, T-H-E, the, O. So this single letter is a syllable. Okay. T yo L O L O G Y G. So totally there are four syllables. 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables. What is the third syllable from the last? G, first one. Law, second one. O, this is the third one. So you put the stress on the syllable O. Then theology. Theology. Next, finally, physiology, physiology. So, what are the syllables? P-H-Y, P-S-I-G-O, this single letter is a syllable. Okay, O, lo, G. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 syllables are there. What is the third syllable from the last? G-Y-G, first one, L-O, lo, second one, and O, this is the third one. So you put the stress on the O. Then physiology. Okay, so these are some examples for the words which end with L-O-G-Y, logy. Now let's see some words which are ending with graphy, G-R-A-P-H-Y, graphy. Okay, so in that case also the stress should be on the third syllable from the last. So you see this spectrography. Spectrography. So first, let's divide this word into syllables. So, S-P-E-C, spec, S-P-E-C, spec, T-R-O, pro, G-R-A, gra, P-H-Y, phi, spec, pro, gra, phi. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables are there and this word is ending with graphy, so the stress should be on the third syllable from the last. So this is the first one, this is the second one, this is the third one. So you put the stress mark on the syllable T-R-O, tro, T-R-O, tro. Then it will be spectrography, spectrography. Okay, now you say this biography. Biography. So, B-I-B-I-O. This single letter itself is a syllable. Okay, understand? So, bio, G-R-A, gra, P-H-Y, phi, biography. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables are there. So, you put the stress mark on the third syllable from the last. 1, 2, 3. This is the third syllable. So, you put the stress mark on O. Then, biography. Biography. Okay. And finally, choreography. Choreography. So, C-H-O, co, R-E, re, yo, gra, phi, choreography. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 syllables are there. So, we need to put the stress on the third syllable from the end. So, 1, 2, O. This is the third syllable. So, you put the stress mark on O. So, it will be choreography. Choreography. Okay. And finally, orthography. Orthography. O-R-T-H-O-G-R-A-P-H-Y. Orthography. So, R, T, H, O, do, gra, phi. R, do, gra, phi. 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables are there. So, you take the third syllable from the last. So, 1, 2, 3. So, the third syllable. So, orthography. So, in this way, if the word is ending with G-R-A-P-H-Y, graphy, or L-O-G-Y, logy, or I-Z-E, or I-T-Y, or I-C-A-L, or I-A-N, then the stress should be on the third syllable from the last. This is the rule number 6. So, what does the rule number 5 say? The rule number 5 says that if a given word is ending with I-O-N, I-A-L, I-C, I-O-U-S or E-O-U-S, then the stress will be on the second syllable from the last. So, with this, we have completed all the examples for all these 6 rules. Okay, so now you just pause this video and take your notes or some paper and note down all these words for preparation. Okay, so this is all about this class. In the next class, let's go to another topic. So until then, bye, take care. And moreover, if you feel this video is useful to you, please like, share and subscribe. Okay, thank you.